from Jammu and Kashmir.
Yes, sir.
What is the present status of J&K? In your opinion, is it under control?
With respect to security scenario?
Security.
Okay. The internal security right now. The internal security right now is under control, but with some exceptions like challenges of insurgency against Indian state and some external forces are acting that are actually instigating the violence. Violent means like bomb blast. Recent bomb blast have taken place in the CRPF vehicle. Same incident repeatedly. Some car hijacking and explosions taken place recently within 3-4 days. So these are the challenges. But right now, as a major threat, there is no such major threat. But internal disturbances have been there, sir.
Recently, our Prime Minister and Prime Minister of Pakistan, they met at a common place.
Yes.
Tell us something about that.
Yeah, they met at Shanghai Cooperation Organization meeting, where that was not a formal meeting, but somehow they interacted and exchanged the good wishes for the both the countries. So that was the interaction that took place in the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, sir.
What were the main, you know, issues which were discussed in that summit?
It was regarding the security scenario of the South Asia along with the Europe and Asian region, and especially the stability of the Afghanistan with the withdrawal of the forces by the United States, sir.
Your opinion regarding removal of 370 from
the
state now?
Okay, so as such, a removal, direct removal will not be the conducive, because the ground realities are such that we should not go with the removal of 370, but at least some amendments and some considerations should be there, like the issue of Article 35A, that is an amendment within the 370 article, that can be considered. But otherwise, going with the simply removal of Article 370, it will be counterproductive for the state, sir, given the conditions that are not ripe as such.
Is it possible?
It can be possible in future, but right now it's not. I think the internal situation is not ripe yet that we go with the removal, and it will be
constitutionally, legally.
There are different views, sir. Experts have expressed that, some experts say that it can be removed under Article 362. I'm sorry. Some jurists have interpreted that it can be removed, but otherwise some have said that until and unless the Constituent Assembly okays it, and along with the state legislature, President cannot, you can remove this article. So there are different interpretations. So the debate is still ripe. We can't say sure for sure.
Okay. You tell me that you have done BSc.
Yes, sir.
Botany, geology and chemistry.
Yes, sir.
So what are degradable and non-degradable pollutants?
Degradable pollutants are those that can be degraded by the microbial activities, microorganisms activities, within a period of time, but non-degradable are the ones that cannot be degraded, and its lifetime is such that it acts as a pollutant for a long period of time. So this is the basic difference.
So plastic is not degradable or non-degradable?
It's non-degradable, sir.
Plastic?
Yes, sir.
But recently we have
some initiatives under biotechnology have been taken place where even plastic can be degraded, but still it's not a pan-India concept, not a global concept. We will still conclude by saying that plastic is still a non-biodegradable waste. The whatever has been done is under laboratory conditions that has not been implemented yet in the ground level, sir.
What is biological magnification?
Yeah, biological magnification is the procedure where we have to employ the microorganisms to reduce the pollutants from the polluted site. And such microorganisms can be fungi, bacteria, etc.
That is phytoremediation we are talking about. I'm talking about the biological magnification.
Oh, sorry.
Not fight
yeah,
or
yeah,
mitigation.
I got your points. I'm sorry, sir. So biomagnification is the increase in the concentration level of a pollutant when it enters the food chain. That is biomagnification, sir.
Example would be DDT.
Yeah, example is DDT. When it enters the food chain, when it moves from one tropic level to another tropic level, at the higher tropic level, the concentration of that very pollutant increases to a, increases at, as it acts as a pollutant then. That is biomagnification.
When World Environment Day is celebrated,
I can make an informed guess, but I am not sure about the exact date. 22nd June is the date, I think, sir.
No, 5th June.
I'm sorry, sir.
World Ozone Day.
Ozone Day. I don't remember the date right now, sorry. Sorry, sir.
You please find out.
Okay.
What are the benefits and disadvantages of joining CISM? Two benefits, two disadvantages.
Benefits with respect to the nation?
CISM.
Okay. Benefits for me or for nation?
Yes, general for the general carriers.
Okay.
Everybody is willing to join CISM
yeah.
only?
Yes, sir. Sir, the advantages that CISF gives us is that it provides the opportunity in the urban areas and where we have a good family life. So that is one such advantage in CISF. Another advantage is we get the opportunity to explore the urban centers like ISRO, metro stations, nuclear plants, and other where we don't get the opportunity with the if we get recruited as assistant commandant in other forces. So this is the advantage in CISF. Disadvantage. If we talk about disadvantage in CISF is we don't get that adventurous life because the other forces provides us to go to remote areas of the country. That is a one such disadvantage because you hardly get opportunity in CISF. Another disadvantage, that second one, is CISF actually don't gives us the opportunity to directly come in conflict with our enemies, because in urban centers we hardly get any opportunity to encounter the hardships that other assistant commandants in other in other jobs face. So this is one such advantage.
Can you tell us something about the recent visits of Prime Minister?
Yeah. After getting elected as Prime Minister, the first visit that he took place was in Maldives, sir. This was his first visit, given the importance that Maldives play in the security scenario of the country, to counter the Chinese influence there, and at the same time, the recent government that has formed in Maldives is pro-India. In fact, we can say that it's, even if it is not pro-India, it go with the balanced approach that it balances. The previous regime there was there in the Maldives, it was directly in conflict with the Indian interest. So this was his first visit to Maldives.
Mr. Deepak.
Yes, sir.
You did your BSc.
Yes, sir.
We were in for the day.
Yes, sir.
So what were you doing?
So after that, I prepared for civil services exam of UPSC. In fact, I have cracked prelims for twice, in written mains for two times. Could not get the opportunity to enter the interview marks by margin of marks. So even after that, I started teaching as a profession in my own state, and sometimes even free of cost to the students. So this was
what do you teach?
Different subjects I teach for UPSC. In my main subject was science and technology and environment science, and other than this I do with some other subjects as well, sir, as I get the opportunity, because it's not my own institute. I somehow visit the institute whenever I whenever they require me to give the lectures.
What is surgical strike?
Surgical strike was the term that was used for the first time when Uri attack took place. After that, Indian forces entered the POK, and it was a surgical strike. The name specifically given was surgical. It means we are not actually in conflict with the enemy country, but only the non-state actors that are acting against the Indian interest. That was a surgical strike. It means we are actually doing something.
Is it legal based in Indian, under international law?
Sir, protecting the national interest is that is the sole responsibility of each and every country. If we are acting against non-state actors, it can't be, we can't say that it's illegal. If we are actually going in conflict with some state actors, that can be illegal, provided they are not harming us in any way.
Act against any non-state actor in any country.
Yeah, till the time they are actually against our interest, national interest, we have to act. We have
the right to act.
No, we have to decide whether circumstances are there for us to act or not. If the circumstances provides us that we have
hot pursuit.
Yes, sir.
Hot pursuit.
I'm not
his name.
Not. Please repeat, sir.
What is hot pursuit?
Hot pursuit.
Yeah.
I'm not sure, but I can make an informed guess, sir.
Okay. As you live in Jammu and Kashmir.
Yes, sir.
Where do you live? Which district?
Riyasi district, sir.
Riyasi district.
Hmm.
How far it is from Leh?
From Leh. Exact distance is not there for me, but at least around 600 kilometers. Yeah.
And from Kashmir Valley?
From Kashmir Valley to Leh, from my district. My district. Yeah, it's around 350. 350 to 400 kilometers.
Okay. And how is terrorist activity in your district?
What, sir?
Is there any terrorist activity in
no,
your
no,
district?
No. My district is entirely peaceful district. There is no such activity. Exceptions are there for example, some in some of the remote areas of the district. But that are, in fact, if we conclude the 10 years, last 10 years, there is hardly any activity, terrorist activity that has taken place within my district. Exceptions are there, like one such recent incident took place that near SMBDU University in my own district. That was one such incident. Even that was not the somehow military personnel have intercepted that terrorist, otherwise that was not the road. Yes, sir.
Jammu and Kashmir Shah.
Yes, sir.
Jainul Abdin ke bare mein. Jainul Abdin.
Jainul Abdin. I'm not aware. Sorry, sir.
Raj Tarangani. Raj Tarangani.
Sorry, sir.
Kashmir history. Pali, Puri Kashmir history, Raj Tarangani.
Okay, sir. I'm not.
Low intensity conflict.
When someone is not able to counter you directly, they adopt these tactics of low intensity conflict, where they are not directly challenging you, but somehow they are challenging you through some proxy members. So that is low intensity warfare, sir.
Like
edge. Yes, sir.
Like edge.
Like the conflict that is right now undergoing in Kashmir.
What is the difference between LOC and LAC?
LOC, line of control, is the border area that is that bifurcates India and Pakistan, and line of actual control is the line that actually bifurcates India and China, sir.
What? And what is the difference between district magistrate and district collector?
District magistrates includes the judicial authority, but district collector as such is the administrative post, I think.
Judicial power है.
Yeah.
Suppose that जैसे कि एक चीज पढ़ते हैं कि अगर किसी को arrest किया जाता है, 24 hours के अंदर उनको magistrate के समक्ष पेश करते
हैं. Yes.
तो वो judicial magistrate के पास पेश करते हैं या executive magistrate?
This is executive magistrate, sir, because the police administration actually, when whenever a convict person is taken into custody, it has to be produced within the 24 hours, and that is the executive. जो प्रोड्यूस करेगा
एग्जीक्यूटिव पावर किसके पास
है डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर्स के साथ
डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर
यस सर
ऑपरेशन बंदर
बंधन
बंदर
बंदर
नाम सुना
है सर
अभी रिसेंट में इंडिया ने ईरान के ऊपर से अपने जितने भी फ्लाइट शुरू किया उसको बंद कर दिया है
ईरान के ऊपर
ईरान के इससे क्या निगेटिव इम्पैक्ट इंडिया की इकोनॉमी पर पड़ेगा भाई पाकिस्तान के साथ भी बंद है ईरान के साथ
सो उसमें क्या होगा सर कि हमारी अर्थव्यवस्था पे इसमें हमें हवाई सफ़र महंगा हो जाएगा क्योंकि हमें अलग रूट्स में जाना पड़ेगा जो कन्वेंशनल रूट्स थे हमारे ट्रेडिशनल रूट्स थे उससे हटकर हमें लंबा रूट पकड़ना पड़ेगा जिसके लिए हमारे जो एक्सपेंसेस होंगे वो बढ़ जाएंगे तेल का खर्चा बढ़ जाएगा
हॉबी क्या है
हॉबी सर मेडिटेशन है क्रिकेट खेलना है और लिसनिंग म्यूजिक टीचिंग
क्रिकेट आप खेलते हैं
यस
जो वर्ल्ड कप हो रहा है वो कौन था इस भाई समाप्त इस समाप्त कौन था
आई एम सॉरी
अच्छा ये आप साइंस के स्टूडेंट हो
यस
गेंद के कितने साइड्स होते हैं
व्हाट सर
बॉल होती है बॉल में कितने साइड्स होते हैं
साइड्स As such, I am not a professional player, sir, but it's just my hobby for the past time. Otherwise, I am not a former cricketer, sir.
Thank you. Your formal interview is over. We will call you for feedback.
Okay.
My big
thank you, sir.